So we looked at some prerequisites to learning decimals. Now we'll clearly list out the different learning objectives under decimal. That is, we'll look at the different concepts or ideas which are important to be learned to be able to say that we have understood or learned decimals completely. So you'll get a list of certain ideas or concepts. You have to pick out all the ideas which form learning objectives to decimals. So out of the list, there are 5 learning objectives to decimals. These objectives will be listed in the order in which they should be learned. The first learning objective is to understand that the place value system can extend to very large numbers as well as to very small numbers indefinitely. That is, there can be a place value less than units, which is tens, hundreds, thousands, and so on. Now, before learning decimals, children often think that there is no number which is smaller than 1, or there is no number that falls between 0 and 1. So, in order to learn decimals, the foremost step is to learn that there are numbers which are less than 1 and can be depicted on the number line. Now, for this, we should understand that a unit can be divided into 10 parts or 100 parts or 1000 parts, and any small part of these 100 parts forms a hundredth division or a hundredth place value. So, an important step is to understand that the place value system will extend even towards the right, that is towards smaller numbers, indefinite. Now, you'll see an activity which shows the need of having the place value system increasing indefinitely towards very small numbers. This kind of activity forms a basis to learning decimals. Let's have a look.
Preview.
Next learning objective is to understand the meaning of decimal point as a symbol. So once we know that there are numbers less than 1 which can be a tenth of a unit or a hundredth of a unit and so on, the next question is how do we represent or write these numbers. Now to answer to that, we have to learn the symbolism of decimals, that is using the decimal point in the correct place in the number. So one should understand the decimal point means the number, the string of numbers following it forms the decimal part, or is the part of the number which is less than 1. The next learning objective in decimals is to understand ordering of decimals. Now one can say that, you know, if you understand the first learning objective very well, that is the place value for decimal numbers, you will automatically understand how to order decimal numbers. But because ordering of decimals is a significant concept to be understood, it is worth being a standalone learning objective. So this is just to ensure that we are focusing enough on this learning objective and paying much attention that people are learning it. So by ordering decimal numbers, we essentially mean a person should know what decimal number is greater than what all other decimal numbers. For example, that 2.3 is greater than 2.0052. The next learning objective is operations on decimals. So we come to the operational part of decimals, where we learn how can we add, subtract, multiply or divide decimal numbers. Finally, another learning objective is to understand the relationship between decimals and fractions and to be able to convert one form of representation to another. Now this is an important skill for decimals because it completes our knowledge of decimals. Now since fractions and decimals are different representations of the same idea or the same type of numbers, it is essential to understand the two representations and how they are related. Now it should also be noticed that a learning objective like understanding the relationship between decimals and persons might not be considered as a learning objective for decimals, because it, even if we do not know about that, our knowledge of decimals as a whole is complete. But if we know that, that is something extra we know, and probably this knowledge would be a learning objective in learning percentages. So now that we know what are the different learning objectives in decimals, we should try to understand how can we assess whether a person has understood these objectives or whether we have succeeded in teaching these objectives. Another possibility is that when we taught something to someone or learned something and skipped certain important parts in the concept, the test we make might be directly corresponding to what all we have learned rather than corresponding to what all we should have learned. That is, the test might be just checking if whatever I have taught someone, has he learned that or not, rather than testing if the person has learned whatever is important in decimals. Now, to avoid these possibilities, it is beneficial to have the test designed before the learning or the teaching process starts. An interesting theory that's called understanding by design talks about the same process. It also calls it the reverse learning process. It says that once you have listed out the different learning objectives or skills that are supposed to be learned as part of a concept or a topic, you should design the test first and then go to learning the topic, because in that process you'll be very sure as to what all things you have to learn and pay special attention to. And once you have completed your learning, it will be an absolute test for you, which will test whether you have learned everything which was important to be learned in the topic. So following this theory, we'll try to design some questions corresponding to each of the learning objectives we just discussed. I'll give you a few questions for some of the objectives and you're supposed to come up with more such questions. So let's have a look at these questions. So we saw some questions which are testing whether a person has learned the different learning objectives or not. The next step when we are learning something important is to check whether there are some common errors or misconceptions that people generally have in this topic.